For the week of November 28th, 2011, this is the Yokosuka Report on Channel 15. Your place for news on the fleet, service members, and our community.
President Barack Obama declared November National Native American Heritage Month, and Yokosuka sailors celebrate with an observance ceremony. Command-managed Equal Opportunity Officer Chief Tasha Wright said the diversity observances, held monthly, are important because of the various cultures represented in the military.
It's very important because we all come from different backgrounds, different walks of life. We have our own ideas and concepts, and the military is a melting pot, so we have everyone here.
Chief Boatswain's Mate Michael Scott Sparkman, guest speaker for the ceremony, said that everyone should do their best to learn about other cultures.
I might not look too much Native American, but I am, and it's part of my history. And as being part of history, it's great for everybody to know the history of where they come from.
Native Americans have participated in United States military actions for more than 200 years. Native American soldiers, sailors, Marines, and airmen have fought in all of this century's wars and armed conflicts. Seaman Shamira, Purifoy, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
Navy Fitness at Fleet Activities Yokosuka held their annual 5K Turkey Trot for CFATE community members and residents with a special participant, a real turkey.
If there's a turkey, I'm definitely catching it, and I'm cooking it.
Well, not an actual turkey.
One of our group exercise instructors and CFLs is participating as our turkey. His name is Corey Howard.
You see, I'm the turkey and stuff, and Thanksgiving's coming around the corner, so I don't want to get caught.
The turkey had a sporting head start on the race, and everyone's goal was to catch up and beat the turkey. Poor turkey.
I am a little concerned that he doesn't make it through before everybody else, yes. He may, you know, lose a wing or two.
Chasing the turkey was a fun challenge for the runners and good competition, but how about the turkey?
Turkey I ate up. There isn't more turkey left.
The fastest runners won Thanksgiving-appropriate prizes like hams, chickens, and, oh, turkeys. The turkey was not available for comment. Petty Officer Chris Henry, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
For some sailors, work is never done. Members of USS Shiloh's 1st Division Deck Department explain the importance of why preservation and maintenance aboard a U.S. Navy vessel is in constant demand.
Pretty much it represents everything that I've done with my time in the Navy and what I'm doing. It shows who I am, my work, and my ethics. So if the ship isn't looking good, then it's a bad rap on my name and my fellow seamen.
Even after more than 6 months in dry dock, these sailors work around the clock continuing to uphold the high standards of operational order throughout the ship.
It may not be the glamorous thing ensuring that the steel decks are in the order and safe repair that they need to be, but it is of the utmost importance. I can tell you that Deck Division doesn't see an early day. The young men and women of the division work really hard. They have a lot of spirit. They have a lot of dedication to their work, which is necessary.
Guarding the ship from the elements is not always an easy task, as one sailor explains.
It's a lot of work. It's hard work, long hours, but seeing progress makes it worth it.
Forward deployed to Commander Fleet Activities Yokosuka, Shiloh's 1st Division, made up of more than 20 sailors, is responsible to ensure the safe working order of all mechanical and ship evolution equipment and operations.
We control all the aviation underway and in port. We do all the rib operations, so we preserve everything that has to do with that. And then we also do a lot of PMS and have to maintain 42 spaces on top of the main deck.
Petty Officer Michael Story, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.